Now guys, today I'm going to be ranting. Hey people, once again, welcome to Kenneth Money Matters. And here we talk about the money mindset. How do you think about money? What's your attitude towards money? We talk about how to make that money. We talk about how to manage that money. We talk about how to enjoy your money. And we talk about how to invest that money and ensure yourself of a lifetime of income. The reason I'm going to be ranting is because there's stupidity and amongst young people. Sometimes I look at young people and I'm like, what the fuck, man? What are you doing? And because this is the truth, man. I feel bad. A lot of people are coming to me with some issues that are just stupid, plain stupid. We're trying to build wealth. We're trying to make money. But some people are just not seeing the need for, you know, taking care of their money. So first of all, before I get into it, I talk to a lot of people about money. I talk to a lot of people about finance. I talk to a lot of young people. And because I'm so passionate about people building wealth, I want you to build wealth. I want you to start slow, be patient, you know, learn the game, learn how the market works, learn how money works, manage your money well, build wealth. It's about building wealth. It's not about having some few coins and here and there and thinking you're rich. It's about long-term wealth building, you know, generational wealth. This is about the black community, guys. This is about us trying to raise our economic standards. So for me, it's more than just money. It's passion. I'm always talking to people and they come to me with certain things. And I understand some of them are quite normal, but some are outrageous and ridiculous. So I just want to look at some of the stupid ways in which Kenyans lose money. And generally, this is to Africans. I don't even think this is just to Kenyans. I think it applies to Africans too. I want to look at some of the stupid ways in which people lose money while thinking they're going to make more money or while trying to make money. And some of them are just plain stupid. I call them stupid because you do not think on your own. Somebody is basically thinking for you. Somebody is basically directing you on your own money. And we cannot afford to be losing money if you're trying to build wealth. If you can't manage your money, one of the principles of making money is managing your money. If you cannot manage the money you have, the little you have, the 1,000, the 2,000, the 10,000, then you don't deserve to be a millionaire. You don't deserve to earn more money. So don't waste your time looking for more money if you can't manage your money. Don't waste your time looking for more income. Don't waste your time trying to invest if you can't manage your money. And that's another thing I tell people when they come to me. I tell them, you know what? Investing in yourself and coming for coaching is something that you need to do so that you protect the millions and millions of money you will make. And someone don't want to pay me, for example, let's say 10,000 or, you know, 20,000 or 5,000 to protect millions of money. Because I will tell you where to put the money. I will tell you which business to do. And I'll be sure about where I'm directing you to. And I will smell scams from afar. But people don't want to invest this money. They always come with all excuses. And I don't care, really. I'm doing this out of passion. The main issue here is people still go out there and lose money. Then they come back to me when they've lost money. Now, that's what I call stupid. And that's why I'm going to rant. So let's look at some of the ways that people in Kenya lose money to scammers in a stupid way. And please don't fall for these things because you will just be stupid too. So number one, someone comes to you and tell you that they need to pray for you. So these pastors we have in Kenya, all of them are money hungry. Most of them are money hungry. Not all of them definitely, but most of them are money hungry. And they're just using people to make money. They're using poor people to make money. They're using young people who are trying to build wealth to make money. So someone gets money, takes a loan for business, and then they are told that your pastor has to pray for you. And the funny thing about this thing is they have to pray for you with your cash right there. What stupid thing is that? If you want to pray for me about my money, you can pray for me on my own. The money will be in the bank. Why do you need to carry money to cash and go to a pastor to pray for you? Now, I call that stupid. Whether you call it religion, you call it God, you call it whatever you call it, but I think that's just plain stupid. So that's number one. People taking their money, their loans, their business money, their profits, to the pastor to pray for them. And they take the whole amount there in cash. And then you think you're going to come back with the money. Now, if that is not stupid, tell me what is stupid. So we have to think. We can't let people think for us. We can't let religion think for us. We can't let other people just take control of our lives and our money the way they want. We have to be people who can think beyond our noses. We have to think beyond. We have to always evaluate every situation and look at what is the reason I'm doing this. Why am I doing this? What's the outcome? Is there a need to do it? So always think of that. That's number one. Two, cryptocurrencies. Kenyans always want to go into these complicated investment options that they don't understand. And I've done a video on Bitcoin, for example. But why are we so obsessed with things we don't understand? Why are we so obsessed with certain complex investments that not even the financial industry understands well how they are running? So you know that Bitcoin is going quite high, Ethereum is going quite high, and now you want to invest in them. You know nothing about Bitcoin, you know nothing about the process of investing in Bitcoin or you investing in cryptocurrency, but you must just do it. So someone approaches you somewhere from Nigeria, from wherever, from abroad, from Romania, from UK, and they want to invest for you. And you rush there with your money and put millions of money. And then you lose money because there was no research done. There was no understanding of this investment strategy. There was no understanding of this investment vehicle. There was no understanding of cryptocurrency. Basically, someone just sold you a lie and you bought it fully with all your money. And then you come back when you now have nothing in your hands. So a lot of Kenyans and young people are losing money through this cryptocurrency bullshit. And I call it bullshit because you don't understand anything about it. People who should be investing in cryptocurrency are people who already have very well diversified portfolios. They are millionaires in their own rights. They don't care about what happens to that other aggressive investments, because cryptocurrencies is a very aggressive investment, and it's an investment that most people don't understand. There's fear of missing out. Young people in Kenya have fear of missing out. They don't want to miss out on the cryptocurrencies. They don't want to miss out on the next big thing. They don't want to miss out on the next, you know, the next Facebook or the next WhatsApp or whatever it is. So they end up investing in very funny things, forgetting the normal things that they use every day, the phones they use, which is, for example, Safaricom, forgetting about, you know, the consumer industry where they eat every single day, the health industry where they go to every single day, the communications industry in which they use the laptops and the computers every day. They forget all those things, but they want to invest in this thing they have never used in their lives. Then we have this online trading thing. I do online trade, I do forex trading, but I've never ever asked anyone for money to trade for them. If you want training, you come for training. I don't know where these people come from whereby they tell you, oh, give me your money, I'll trade for you and I'll give you like 30% return. That's bullshit. Nobody's gonna trade your money. If they were able to get 30% return consistently, they would do it with their own money. It's very simple. If you want to multiply my money at 30% online trading, then please do to your own money. What someone can do to you with regards to online trading is train you and give you the strategies. But the mental capacity required, the discipline required, the focus required, the research required, the time required, there is no one who can do that for you. Nobody can do that for you. Yes, there are companies out there, big companies that can do, like banks, for example, but that will be a completely different arrangement. Where not whereby you have an individual who tells you, oh, I know how to trade Forex. And you know, you just hand over your money and expect to get that money back. That's stupid, man. Nobody's gonna do it for you. I understand online trading so well, and I know the mental requirements of trading. It's nothing to do with the money. It's about the mental capabilities. And if you do not understand someone's mental situation, you do not understand someone's circumstances in life, you cannot convincingly say someone will be able to trade for you. Now, if you give someone money to trade for you and they give you returns for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 3-4 months, you think, oh, this is really good. You put everything back in and then everything goes down. Now, if that is not stupid, what is stupid? So stop with this online trading bullshit. If you want to trade online, it's okay, but you have to learn. You have to get the skills. You have to get the knowledge. You have to be patient. You have to be disciplined. And you have to speak to someone who has done it, who can train you through it. This rush whereby you go to school to learn engineering for 7 years, you go to school to learn being a lawyer for 7 years, but when you come to trading, you want to learn within 1 day and make money within 1 day and become a millionaire within 1 day. It's not gonna happen. Forget about it, man. Stupid process of losing money. A lot of people are losing money through this channel, and I call it stupid because every single time, there's no one who can multiply your money. You have to remember that. There must be a clear investment strategy. If someone tells you about investment, let them tell you the strategy of that investment. What is the portfolio of that investment? What's the performance, historical performance of that investment? And what's the evidence of that investment? And then there are these people always approached by foreigners. You know, some foreigner somewhere is helping me make this. Some foreigner somewhere in Congo is helping me get gold. Some foreigner in Uganda is helping me get gold. Someone is helping me get oil in Nigeria. These foreigners that come to Kenyans, and they want to help you make money. Why don't they make money in their own country? Why don't they make money where they are? Someone approaches you on a phone, on a WhatsApp, and they want to help you buy Bitcoin. They want to give you 50% or 100% return on your money. They want to multiply your money in the next 3 days, 4 days, I don't know. Why would someone want to multiply your money? Why don't they go and multiply their own money? Me, I think I would not be out there in the streets looking for someone to multiply their money. If I can multiply my own, I can multiply my own and sit well in my house, relax, enjoy the life. It's bullshit to think that someone is gonna make me money, just sit out there and just start making me money. So somebody tells you that they want to multiply your money and you buy it. As a normal person, a young person who has brains, I think that's really stupid. And that's why I have to call it out. Any investment must have an objective, a strategy, a historical performance, and evidence of that particular investment, and not by some foreigner. You have to know, where does it happen? How does it happen? It has to be something very clear, very straightforward. I understand being conned. Sometimes you can be conned because some conmen are very, 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 very good at what they do. But there are some that are just outright stupid, whereby they just come to you and ask you for money and they want to multiply it. In the next 3-4 days, they will give you 400,000 out of 200,000. That is bullshit, and that's stupid if you give your money out. And a lot of normal people, doctors, lawyers, people who have good standing in society, lose money this way. And then we have relationships, of course. People lose money in relationships. Somebody is sitting somewhere, they're lying to you about their condition, about their situation. You are in love, you love them, I don't know. And therefore, you start sending money to these people. So these relationships whereby someone is always abusing you financially, you need to wake up from it. If you realize in a relationship, you are the one who is always carrying the financial burdens, and you're the one most likely always ensuring that someone is okay, the house is running okay, or if someone is living somewhere else, you're the one always sending money. That's financial abuse, and you need to wake up from that. That's called love stupidity. Because I do not understand why someone you may have not met, for example, you met them online, would want your financial assistance. If you meet someone online, meet first in person, have a normal relationship first. A lot of young people are meeting people online, then they start sending money. So they send money to these partners, and then these people get lost most of the time. Or sometimes even ladies nowadays keep a lot of men in their houses. They pay everything, the money is sitting, thinking of nothing, no ambition, no dreams, no focus in life. So in that situation, I don't blame the man, I blame the lady. Why are you keeping someone in your house? Why are you keeping somebody? Every single person is in a position to work, should work and earn their own money. Relationships are making young people lose money. You're losing money by sending money abroad, these online relationships and online datings. You're losing money by keeping people in your houses, people who can work and earn their own money. This applies to both men and women. But recently in Kenya, most women are keeping men. I have to say this because I know. So we have to think through. We have to think through everything. Be logical. Think like you're a young person. So that's a stupid way of losing money. And then, of course, we have people losing money through family. Family is always asking you for money and you are constantly giving them money. Family can never let you rest. The moment they know you earn some little money, they're on your case every single time. You're doing business, you are in employment, you're constantly helping family. You're constantly the one making the family run. It's not your responsibility. This life, there's a certain point whereby it is everyone for themselves. You have to ensure that you can run your own life before you help other people run their own lives. So again, family make people lose money sometimes, but I'm not saying don't help family. It's very important to help. I help my own family too when I need to, and they help me too when there's need. But a situation whereby someone becomes fully dependent and they have skills, they have a brain, they have, you know, a physique that can work, that is also stupid. So there are a lot of people who are keeping families. They have become the breadwinners of people who can actually have their own homes and their own families. So you are basically creating dependency within the society. And this is something we don't want. We don't want to create dependency. Help people with ideas. Let's normalize helping family with ideas. Let's normalize helping people with normal ideas of growth and how they can make their own money, how they can invest their own money, and how they can grow in life. Giving someone money, giving someone handouts, making them dependent will not help the situation. And this is where most people are. A lot of young people have fallen in a dependent situation because of money from abroad, for example, because some brother, some sister who is in the US is sending them some little money. Therefore, they forget about their dreams. We lose money this way in a stupid manner because we don't want to just say it out, call it out and say, you know what, this is something I'm not going to do. So guys, let's think. There are so many ways people lose money. People are always telling you they want to invest for you. Make sure you know that kind of investment. This chamas that people join, some friendships that are financially abusive, make sure you know. Chamas are good, yes, and I understand that. I've actually been taken to school through chamas, I do believe, but there are certain chamas that make people lose money. So many chamas nowadays are not genuine. Some people just come together on the internet and collect money, and then someone disappears with the money. So if you go and have a chama with the people you understand, people you know their financial values, their financial goals, their financial objectives, their financial standings, their financial management values too. So make sure you know the people you are starting a chama with. Don't just start a chama for the sake of starting a chama. And this is very important. Don't start a chama for the sake of it. Always know the people you're starting a chama with. If you're going to get into any kind of chama, make sure you know the financial values, the financial objectives of that chama, and look at the possibilities of losing money. Always make sure those loopholes are completely sealed before you get into the chama business. So it has to be within a particular structure where money flows within the structure and everything is contained within that structure. Otherwise, this rant video has been so long. There are so many ways people are losing money in Kenya through scammers. So many ways, guys. I'm just saying, you know what, be alert. If you want to build wealth, if you want to make money, we cannot be losing money to scammers all the time. We can't be losing money with just some stupid ways, you know. We have to be alert. We have to be awake. We have to know what you want to do. We have to know that there's no way you can build wealth if you can't manage what you have currently. So guys, thank you so much. I know it's been a rant video, and because I feel so bad about so many young people losing a lot of money, And when they're already climbing the ladder, they come back down and it's affecting them. So guys, please, 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 please be aware. You can talk to someone, ask someone before you make a decision, reevaluate and reevaluate. It's never wrong to go over an idea more than once and make sure it's okay. All right, guys, I thank you. Till next time, subscribe. See you in the next video.